As you know, we bake most of our bread here ourselves instead of buying store-bought bread. Myself, I can usually only handle making one or two loaves at a time with the KitchenAid mixer. Usually, I'll bake one loaf and that will last us for a couple days and then I'll make a fresh one. But then my husband sometimes gets involved in the bread baking and he used to be a baker. So he likes to do it production style, and he'll end up making anywhere from 9 to a dozen loaves of bread at a time, and we'll freeze them up and put them in the deep freezer. But when we do that, occasionally I'll find that wayward loaf somewhere down the bottom of my freezer that has got bashed around a bit and maybe has got a bit dry. And it's not very good for eating toast or anything like that with. So what I'll do is I'll cut up the bread into croutons and make savory croutons. And usually I'll throw in, oh, about a teaspoon of salt and a teaspoon of pepper, a tablespoon of dry garlic powder, a tablespoon of Italian herb seasoning or oregano, and a tablespoon of olive oil or sunflower oil, whatever I have in stock. And then I'll bake the cubes on a foil-lined sheet for about 20 minutes at 350 degrees Fahrenheit. Now, there's a lot of things you can do with the savory croutons. They're good as a topping on soup or salad. You can make a dressing or a stuffing for meats and stuff it in a turkey or a good-sized chicken or even butterfly open a pork tenderloin and stuff some of that in there. And you don't need any extra ingredients. And then roll the pork tenderloin up and tie it with some butcher string and put it in the oven to bake. Another thing you can make with the savory croutons is you can bake an egg strata with it, which is essentially kind of like a quiche, but the crust on the bottom is made with dried bread. And since it's got the savory spices in there too, you don't have to do very much to it other than some eggs, some cream, maybe throw in a little bit of sausage or ham and some other little vegetables and have a strata. And another thing that I've made with it that I should do a video sometime on is baking a savory tomato bread pudding. And since I've got about a dozen quart jars of my homemade stewed tomatoes down in the basement, I may be making that sometime very soon. Well, all I'm waiting for them now is to cool off, and I'm going to store them in a big tin that I have to keep them dry. Now, they do have a little bit of oil on them, so they're not going to really last that long, but they will have probably a shelf life of a couple of weeks if they're stored in a good dry container. Well, that's my video of the day. Just a reminder that even if you find a wayward loaf in your freezer, to always try to save your daily bread. And I made a small bowl of applesauce today too, so my kitchen's been smelling up really nice.